Couch Mental Session, Euphoria, You, Poo, The Morning Show. Oh! Hello everybody, welcome to my channel and Happy New Year. So, this is an exciting time. I don't know why it's an exciting time, but it's just an exciting time. You know, we're in a new year, it's a new decade, it's my first video, and I'm really excited. So, you know, at the end of 2019, people were like doing their list of best movies of 2019, best movies of like, best TV shows of 2019. And like, we still had a week left of 2019. Like, they didn't have the patience to wait for 2019 to be over. Sit down, relax, look over the year, and then pinpoint the shows that, you know what, they were the absolute best. So today's video is actually a compilation of, in my opinion, the best shows of 2019. So like, this is the thing, I had a whole list like that. I realized that I watch a lot of television because look, it's a lot. I realized that I watched a lot of TV last year as opposed to movies. So there are a lot of the movies that I'm now catching up on. I think I had like 25 or like 30 shows, and I'm trying to compress it to like 10 or like 5. And I can't do 5 shows. If I do 5 shows, I'd feel like I left some out. So one of, I think, the best shows of last year was Succession. So if you don't know what Succession is, Succession is on HBO and it follows the Roy family. So the Roy family, they're like an media corporation, and it's fashioned after the Murdoch family. That's the Fox broadcast, Fox News. It's fashioned after them, like, well, it's loosely based around them. And there's a thing about Succession, like Succession is one of those shows that you want them to do well so that more people discover it, but at the same time you like the fact that it's under the radar, so like you can enjoy it in peace because the show is so good. So if you want like a Game of Thrones-esque show but without all the dragons and things, and you know, like family, like proper family drama, I think you should watch Succession. And the great thing about Succession is that there's no good character. Like, all the characters in the show are terrible, and that's what I like about it. Like, they don't try to like paint anybody in like big strokes or like this person is all good. No, they all have like their soft side, they all have their great side, but they are all terrible people. So one of my best show, I put it high up on the list, is Succession on HBO. I think everybody should watch it. My next best show is You on Netflix. Now, what most of people are compiling their list of best shows, it was, I think, 25th or 24th December, and the season 2 of You dropped on the 26th of December on Netflix. Now, when the first ever season of You came out on Lifetime, and Lifetime canceled it, because I'm sure they were like, nobody's even watching it anyways, and so canceled. And then Netflix took it up, and it just blew up. Like, You just blew up. Penn Badgley is amazing. You know, when I was on Gossip Girl, he was Lonely Boy, and everybody was like, nobody liked him in Gossip Girl, but he went on You, and he just went up. Like, Penn Badgley is amazing as Joe Goldberg. It just shows how much people see that someone's a stalker and still be in love with the person. This is the thing, I saw someone say on Twitter that, oh, if you take out the murders, Joe Goldberg is such a sweetheart. And I'm like, no, that the murders, that's what defines him. You can't take away the murders and say that, you know, let's take away the murders, he's great. But You, in my opinion, one of the best shows of 2019. They deserve all the flowers. I think that it was amazing. This is how you feel like after the show. You're like, you shouldn't be rooting for anybody in the show, but then you like, you still want to like be sucked in. And that's what I like about it. Murder, love, what's there not to love? And also for this video, I decided to take out the shows that are like limited series. Like, you know, those shows that you know that there's no way they're going to come back for a season 2. Like When They See Us and Chernobyl and the others. Because even though I wish I could add it to the list, if I add it, it would be so long. And also one of my favorite shows from last year was Pose. Now, there's a thing about Pose. Last year was Pose's second season. And the same as with You, the second season of You was like way better than season 1. The second season of Pose was better. The storyline was more coherent, and everything just seemed to be very streamlined. Pose season 2 gave us like one of the best scenes in television. Pray Tell being Pray Tell, you know, the part where he went to see Blanca and Blanca thought she was dying, and when he also thought he was dying, that dynamic was just amazing. When Candy died was like one of the, like, it was really sad, but it was one of the best parts of TV because they made like this character that people didn't really like, but people just tolerated, and they made her become this character. And I was Pose season 2 was really great. So I think that that's also one of my best shows of 2019. And Billy Porter deserves all the awards he's getting because he is amazing. Like, I don't go, like, there's no two ways about it. When he comes to the scene, he just electrifies. So he has a sort of energy that is just very palpable. And another one of the shows I liked was The Morning Show. When Apple TV Plus released their slate of shows, a lot of people, like, I saw the reviews for The Morning Show and a lot of the critics slammed it for some strange reason. They're like, it's not nice and it's, I mean, it's terrible. And Jennifer Aniston, well, I think Jennifer Aniston was the only person that they all agreed on was great, but then they're like, the rest of them didn't seem nice. And so Apple TV Plus, The Morning Show, Steve Carell, Reese Witherspoon, and Jennifer Aniston. Like, already these three characters are like amazing, and you already know Reese Witherspoon is like, she's really good from Big Little Lies. Steve Carell, he's fantastic. Jennifer Aniston, they're these three are very fantastic, like, actors, and to put them together was really great. So this is the thing about The Morning Show. The Morning Show was supposed to be a comedy. It was slated as a 30-minute comedy, but I don't know why they decided to make it into a drama, but whoever made that decision, kudos. After I watched the first episode, I was a bit reluctant about it, but by the fourth episode and by the time Jennifer Aniston was just slamming her hands on the table, I was sold. Okay, I feel like Jennifer Aniston is really great, and I feel like The Morning Show is like one of the best shows for last year, and I can die on this hill. Euphoria on HBO. Now, this is the thing about Euphoria. I feel like when Euphoria came, I was one of the people that was very about it, because the scenes in Euphoria are very cringe worthy. That is, if you're not really comfortable with like nudity and like sex between like teenagers, like drug intake and everything. But the characters are good. Also, these characters are also not like all that lovable because they all have their flaws. And I think Zendaya does a great job in Euphoria. Now, Euphoria follows teenagers in high school, and you know, these are not just any teenagers gossiping or anything. No, these teenagers are on drugs. They are showing, like, Euphoria just takes you very deep into a world that you think does not exist. And for a lot of times I was very uncomfortable because I'm like, wow, like, are teenagers really doing this? Are they really taking this much drugs? Another one of the best shows for 2019 was Snowfall. So Snowfall follows Franklin Saint, who was like this, he's this young guy in LA, and he gets into the crack game. And Damson Idris is an amazing and phenomenal actor. So he really brings Franklin Saint to life. And I think that for season 3, they just upped the ante. Season 3 was amazing. The stakes were high. You know, the CIA, all those people involved in drugs, you know. So Snowfall was amazing. One of the best shows for last year. And Snowfall is also one of those shows that you really wish a lot more people watch, because the acting is so good, the storyline is so good, and you also don't want a lot of people to watch it, because if a lot of people watch it, then it ceases to become your show, you know. That's just how I feel. And Watchmen, I think that getting to the end of last year, Watchmen was one of the shows that, like, you know, you just sit up and watch it. I just finished watching the Watchmen movie that came out in 2009. Because before Watchmen came out, I know a lot of people were like iffy about it, because they're like, can Damon Lindelof pull this off? And I'd never known, I'll confess, I didn't know about the Watchmen comic books. All I know is that a lot of people, for a lot of like websites and things, the Watchmen were like one of the worst movies ever, in their opinion. So when it was going to be translated to TV, a lot of people were like, ooh, can they do it well? Can they not do it well? But it was amazing. And I think that Regina King is a goddess. I think that she is phenomenal. And I'm one of those people that don't think that Watchmen has to come back for a season 2. I'm sure I'll probably do like a whole separate video about that. But I think that this is a great season 1. Like, it tells a complete story, and there's no more stories to tell. Stranger Things. I think Stranger Things was one of the shows that was really great last year. Stranger Things season 3 was the best season. Personally, I feel like season 1 was great, season 2 was eh, but the season 3 just told a packed story from beginning to end. It was light, it was funny. I didn't think I'd enjoy it as much as I did, but from beginning to end of season 3, it was pow, 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 and it was done. And what more can you ask for from a season? You know, like from a season of television, you want action, you want drama, you want the everything, you want to feel everything. And Stranger Things did that. So honorable mentions for me for shows that were like really great last year. Killing Eve, amazing. A Million Little Things, I love it. How to Get Away with Murder is their last season. And who does acting like Viola Davis? Nobody. Modern Love, New Amsterdam, The Prodigal Son, The Good Place, Good Girls, Titans, Why Women Kill, The Handmaid's Tale, Treadstone. I watched so much television last year. The good, the bad, the mid, the worst, the best. I watched it all last year. And this is my list of like the best shows in my opinion for last year. So let me know in the comments below what show you absolutely loved watching last year. What show in your opinion was the best television show for last year? Okay, I know I've not included everything because oh my god, there were like over 500 scripted shows last year. I can't include everything. I don't think I included comedy in this list because I have my personal gripes about comedy. And you know, I'll see you on my next video, which might probably be the Oscar nominations.